Happy Sunday, fun day. Welcome to the number one daily Bitcoin pod. In today's show, I'll be breaking down the latest Bitcoin technical analysis as we do each and every day. And quoting Max Keiser, Keiser report in 2011 put Bitcoin on the map. Millions heard the call. We created hundreds of thousands of Bitcoin millionaires globally with hundreds of shows over 10 years. These facts get overlooked during this period of Russia phobia. Sadly. Also, I'll be sharing the latest from Jan 3's Samson Mao, as well as Hong Kong to enhance digital asset regulation in 18 months, as well as the worst of the selling is now over, even as investors grapple with the growth scare, according to Fundstrat's Thomas Lee. We'll also be discussing 4 years in, MicroStrategy's Bitcoin gamble beats Warren Buffett's warning. And in fact, exactly 4 years ago today, Michael Saylor became the first CEO to add Bitcoin to his treasury. And ever since, MicroStrategy has bought 226,000 BTC worth $13 billion. That's 150 BTC a day for 1,500 days. Absolutely legendary. We'll also be discussing incredible Trump plan to take on the banks revealed amid Bitcoin and crypto price surge. Also, we'll be discussing the latest from Rich Dad's Robert Kiyosaki declaring a market crash has arrived. He also projects Bitcoin smashing $10 million very easily. We'll also be discussing the latest and greatest of what's happening in the market. All this plus so much more in today's show. If you're new to the channel, very important to smash those likes, subscribe, then hit the bell icon to turn on all notifications to receive daily premium crypto news alerts every single day, just like this. Today is pod episode number 1727. I'm your host, JV. It's August 11th, 2024. So happy August 11th, fam. It's Sunday fun day, so you already know. Let's kick it off with our market watch as we do every day. You should be able to see Coin360 on your screen. We're hovering at around 59,000 at the time of the live stream, down 3% on the day for Bitcoin. Ether is trading at 2,500. Solana down 6%. XRP down 6%. Cardano down 5%. Most of the market pulled back right now and in the red. And checking out CoinMarketCap.com. The current crypto market cap sits at $2.09 trillion. So it's back on the decline. The Bitcoin market cap also back on the decline at $1.16 trillion. And we got $47 billion in volume past 24 hours with the Bitcoin dominance at 56.5%. And look at that ETH dominance, the lowest. Whoa, 15%. Crazy, right? Now, checking out top 100 crypto gainers past 24 hours, virtually nothing because everything is correcting and in the red. My question for you, which altcoins, if any, are you bullish on for this particular bull cycle? And checking out the crypto bubbles, and then we'll look at the crypto greed and fear index. Crypto bubble shows us on the day virtually everything correcting and in the red. And zooming out on the monthly to get a broader perspective, it's like 90 to 95% of the market pulled back and in the red. We do have XRP up 17% on the month, and that's because the lawsuit settlement versus the SEC, they had to pay $125 million in fines. And checking out the Crypto Greed and Fear Index, today we're back at a 39. Yesterday was a 40, last week a 34, and last month a 25 in extreme fear. So there you have it. Crypto fam. We're live and in the flesh. Let's dive into today's Bitcoin technical analysis. Check out some of the live charts and where the price action will likely take us next. The headline here reads, Bitcoin metric calls local bottom as traders eye sub 60,000. Bitcoin price. That's right. Bitcoin signaling a third local bottom in 2024 as the leading Bitcoin price metric sees room for growth. Fresh research from CryptoQuant on August 8th shows the bullish move from the network value to transaction golden cross tool. Bitcoin has fielded warnings of another breakdown on Bitcoin / USD this week as the moving averages produce a so-called death cross. However, the longer-term picture is unclear as other market indicators call for an enduring rebound. Amongst them is the NVTGC, described by CryptoQuant as a volatility gauge similar to the Bollinger Bands. NVT compares the Bitcoin market cap to the value of transactions within a given time frame, and the Golden Cross Edition compares long-term and short-term NVT values. The result is a rough guide to local market tops and bottoms, and in 2024, three such bottom signals have been produced, quoting them here. If the NVTGC rises above 2.2 points, which is the red zone, it indicates the price is overheating for the short-term trend, and we are in a local top area. On the other hand, if the NVTGC falls below 1.6 points, which is the green zone, it indicates that the price is cooling down excessively, and we're in the local bottom area, as outlined here in the chart. Now, they also noted, the analyst, that the two previous bottom signals, which occurred on January 18th and July 12th, were followed by subsequent Bitcoin price gains of 78 and 23%. Respectively, as he shares here, currently we're in a local bottom area, according to the NVTGC. Can the price go deeper? Yes, but we can expect the short-term trend to turn positive in this area. Bitcoin, meanwhile, traded around 60,000 through much of the weekend. That's right. Here you're looking at the four-hour chart, and in a moment I'll be pulling up some of the live charts. Despite holding support during out-of-hours trading, Bitcoin did not convince everyone, with some popular traders seeing the potential for a fresh dip. As Mr. Crypto points out here, says we're heading back down to 57,000. Then we have Crypto Tony, who called for 58.3, which we're on the cusp of reclaiming here any moment. So quoting him here, maybe one more retest of the lower lows before full reversal. Blockchain tech expert El Jaboom continued, and part of his latest commentary comparing the current price action to a year ago when Bitcoin briefly dipped to $25,000. So let me know, fam, where you feel the bottom will likely be. And before I pull up some of the live charts, I got to give my flowers and respect where it's due. Quoting Max Kaiser, this message from Kaiser Report in 2011 put Bitcoin on the map. Millions heard the call. We created hundreds of thousands of Bitcoin millionaires globally with hundreds of shows over 10 years. These facts get overlooked during this period. Russophobia, sadly. That's right. The show was on RT, which is ultimately Russia TV, Russia Times, whatever it stood for there. And I actually have the quote back from 2011. I'm just going to play it. It's in the Roadcaster here. Check it.
Bitcoin top 100 rich list from 3rd of June, 2011. Here's a little video I made of the top 100. As you can see, it's they're all anonymous.
This is fantastic. This is the new Forbes fortune list, isn't it? These are the Bitcoin fortunes. And notice, yes, all numbers, it's pure anonymous. And this is the biggest story of this decade going forward, is the transition from the old way of doing business around the world to the Bitcoin way of doing business, which is purely anonymous. And this is the great achievement of the global insurrection against banker occupation. Bitcoin is the currency of the resistance.
Boom, nailed it right there. Bitcoin is the currency of the resistance, and that's also something he coined, the global insurrection against banker occupation. And then JV threw that in some bars. Hang the bankers. Start with Jamie Dimon. But anyways, family, classic. And quoting Jan3 Samson Mao, the basis for the 83,000 Bitcoin figure in Taiwan's gold reserves relative to that of the UK, Taiwan has 422, I guess the T stands for trillion, versus UK with 310 trillion. So Taiwan has 35% more gold. The UK has 61,000 BTC. So Taiwan should have 35% more too. And that's Samson Mao ultimately orange pilling the nation of Taiwan. So let's freaking go. And I don't know if this T is standing for tons or trillion, so I'm not sure, just FYI. But anyways, let's look at some of the live charts, family. Here's the 1 month. Let's start zoomed in at the 1 hour, and then we'll work our way out. And again, this is live and in the flesh right now, family. Switch up the scene so it's cleaner. There you go. You can see we're currently above 58,700. In the past 20 minutes, we already dropped over $1,000. So we're currently corrective, as you can see. But we do have a target on the 1 hour for a bullish flag sitting at 69,891. Could you say 69 G's, baby? And zooming out a little from here, we'll look at the 4 hour chart. As you can see here, we had 1, 2, 3, 4 consecutive red candles on the 4 hour. That means 16 hours of bearishness since yesterday, unfortunately. Not looking so pretty at the moment. And checking out the 1 day, you can see just the other day, we had a massive green candle, almost a god candle. I would define it as a demigod candle because it was over 5,000 on the daily. But we did have today, clearly, as you can see, a very corrective red candle. And zooming out, we'll check out the weekly, which we still have that cup and pattern or cup and handle pattern sitting at $125,700. And we'll zoom out once more, get a quick look at the monthly chart. As you can see on your screen here, the monthly chart shows us thus far August looking like it's going to be a red candle, but it's still early. We're not even halfway through with the month. But let me know your thoughts where you feel price action is likely heading next. And do you think the lows are in when we tapped just the other day, $49,000 before pumping right back to 62. Let me know your thoughts. But yeah, yo, let's keep it moving. Next story, here's the latest with Hong Kong. The headline reads, Hong Kong to enhance digital asset regulation in 18 months. That's right. Hong Kong is poised to enhance its digital asset regulation within the next 18 months, marking a significant step in its mission to become a global hub for financial technology. At the Foresight 2024 annual summit, David Chu, member of the Legislative Council of the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region, outlined the city's strategic plans to attract technology talents, build new infrastructure, and establish robust legislative supervision. He emphasized that this initiative is crucial for the technology industry over the next 5 to 10 years. The digital asset industry has made significant progress in the past few years, but we're still in a very early stage. We should establish a sound exchange system and soon introduce legislation related to stablecoins. Stablecoins is a type of crypto pegged to stable assets like fiat currencies and are expected to be introduced in Hong Kong by the end of this year. And according to the analysts, sandbox tests have, or I shouldn't say analyst, but that guy Chu, they have tests already been carried out, and the government aims to enhance the supervision and enforcement of legislation related to digital asset financial products within 1 to 1.5 years. The next phase will encourage project parties to explore more innovative financial products in Hong Kong. Clearly, they want to become a cryptocurrency hub, and they're leading in their actions, hence why we even got Bitcoin ETFs now officially in Hong Kong. Now, the Hong Kong Monetary Authority recently announced the first participants in its stablecoin issuer sandbox on July 18th. These participants include a company linked to significant Chinese e-commerce retailer, a local fintech firm, and a coalition of Standard Chartered Bank, Animoca Brands, and Hong Kong Telecommunications. How many of you have been to Hong Kong? Let me know. I've been there before. I actually would do my visa run in Hong Kong when I was living in the mainland of China back in 2010 and 2011. However, we got Jindong Coinlink Tech Hong Kong Limited, a subsidiary of JD Tech Group, is among these participants and plans to issue a one-to-one stablecoin linked to Hong Kong's dollar. However, the company has clarified that inclusion in the sandbox does not equate to endorsement or licensure to issue stablecoins. This planned stablecoin legislation underscores Hong Kong's pro-crypto financial approach, aiming to foster innovation while ensuring regulatory oversight. On July 23rd, CSOP Asset Management, one of China's largest asset managers, launched Asia's first Bitcoin futures inverse product in Hong Kong. The CSOP Bitcoin Future Daily Inverse product follows the successful launch of the firm's Bitcoin futures ETF in December of 2022. So there you go, yo. Mass adoption of crypto seems to be going that way over there in Hong Kong. So more power to them. Hopefully the mainland to follow. And it seems everyone's embracing stablecoins. There's a lot of opportunity there. If you think about it, you have Brad Garlinghouse of XRP. They just launched or are in the process of launching their own stablecoin. And look at the success of Tether USDT. Clearly, it's the first crypto stablecoin. They got the first mover's advantage, but they're absolutely crushing it right now. There's a lot of opportunity in that, and I think they see that. Here's the latest with Fundstrat's Thomas Lee that made the headline. Worst of the selling is now over, even as investors grapple with growth scare, according to the Fundstrat CEO Tom Lee. That's right. Investing veteran Thomas Lee says the worst of the recent correction of financial market has already passed likely. In a new interview on CNBC, the Fundstrat founder says he is looking at the volatility index, a popular gauge of expected volatility in the stock markets. And according to Lee, the VIX suggests that the markets won't see significantly lower prices Quoting them here, the thing that we're watching is the VIX spike to 60 on Monday, which is the third highest reading ever. And the VIX futures curve inverted, which was the steepest inversion since the pre-pandemic times. Both are starting to normalize. I think the VIX, as it closes below 20, and as the VIX futures term structure uninverts, that tells us the worst of the panic is behind us. I don't think it means we won't have ripple effects, because we know there's some trap bulls and there's still some nervousness around Iran and how much of this yen carry trade has to unwind. But I think the worst of the selling pressure is behind us. And last week, he said that the other side of the correction, the current market dip, will look like a growth scare, which describes investors' concern about the U.S. economy's health. The investor says that improving weekly jobless claims could be an indicator that confirms a recovery for markets in the near future, as he shares here. Well, I think investors, when it comes to the growth scare side, have something they can check every week, which is weekly jobless claims, because that was a positive surprise on Thursday, and a lot of it came from Texas. Texas had a big drop in weekly claims week over week. The fact that the markets reacted so positively on Thursday to that jobless claims numbers puts me in the camp that that's one of the big drivers, because we had a better than expected claims numbers than the market popped. I think the growth scare is what's on investors' minds. So there you go. Do you agree with Thomas Lee that the worst of it is already over? I want to know your thoughts there. And let me know your sentiment in the markets as far as the global financial markets family. But anyways, fam, keep the comments flowing. It's always appreciated. But let's dive to our next story of the day. Discuss the latest with MicroStrategy. This headline reads, 4 years in, MicroStrategy's Bitcoin gamble beats Warren Buffett's warning. And before I read you the actual story, I also want to update you here. Exactly 4 years ago today, Michael Saylor became the first CEO to add Bitcoin to his treasury. Ever since, MicroStrategy has bought 226,000 BTC, worth $13 billion. That's 150 BTC a day for 1,500 days. Absolutely legendary. And more recently, he made an announcement of converting more convertible notes to make another $2 billion Bitcoin purchase. So they're stacking biddies like there's no tomorrow. But here's the latest regarding the story. MicroStrategy purchased its first Bitcoin stash on August 10, 2020, becoming the first publicly traded company to adopt the crypto as its primary treasury reserve asset. 4 years later, the bold move has evolved into a defining strategy for the company that has outpaced even the returns of Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway. That's right. As of August 10th, 2024, MicroStrategy had 226,500 BTC, worth $13.771 billion in reserves, which it acquired at an average cost of around $37,000. With Bitcoin currently trading at roughly $60,000, MicroStrategy is now sitting on unrealized profits of about $5.39 billion. And despite the substantial gains, Michael Saylor's company has maintained its Bitcoin holdings, choosing not to liquidate any of its accumulated assets. Smart. Now, it has expressed its intention to continue accumulating the biddies, further evidenced by its most recent purchase on August 1st. Now, the value of MicroStrategy's MSTR stock has responded bullishly to the Bitcoin purchases, having surged by around 1,000% since August of 2020. In comparison, that is 1.5 times higher than Bitcoin's returns and 16 times higher than the returns of the S&P 500 index in the same period. Now, interestingly, Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway Class A stock, BRK.A, has significantly underperformed compared to MSTR since MicroStrategy's initial Bitcoin purchase. BRKA has only gained 104% during this period, with Buffett's persistent negative stance towards Bitcoin keeping Berkshire from exploring crypto investments. And in 2018, Buffett called Bitcoin rat poison squared. His close associate and the late Charlie Munger, who I believe passed, I think it was January of this year, correct me if I'm wrong, went a step further and predicted that the Bitcoin price would crash to zero. Obviously got it wrong, calling it a disgusting product in his statement in 2021. Still, Bitcoin and MSTR have performed better than Buffett's top stock holdings, namely Apple, American Express, and Bank of America, in the recent years. However, some traders expressed their intentions to short MSTR stock. The investment firm Carisdale Capital, Arian, that the trading is unjustifiable premium to Bitcoin, quoting them here. The software business is worth $1 billion, maybe $1.5 billion, somewhere in between. It is not worth very much, said the chief investment officer of Carisdale Capital. Bitcoin prices have to go up for the value of the company to increase. If they go down, the value of the company goes down. The company should be trading at the value of Bitcoin. Our argument is go short MicroStrategy, go long Bitcoin. Very interesting there. But let me know your thoughts surrounding MicroStrategy and them being, I believe, the largest corporate holder of Bitcoin in the world. The only ones that hold more than MicroStrategy and Bitcoin are some of the massive asset managers like BlackRock. I think they did $20 billion in volume into their Bitcoin ETF, which launched back in January. So they now have like over 300 or maybe even as much as 400,000 Bitcoin. And once we had GBTC, who was the largest holder of Bitcoin with over 600,000, but the majority of that Bitcoin was dumped since the conversion of their trust into a Bitcoin ETF. But there you have it, family. Let me know your thoughts with the Giga Chad as they continue to accumulate. Our next story, here's the latest with the Trump plan. And then we'll discuss Rich Dad Robert Kiyosaki's projection of Bitcoin hitting $10 million easily, as he says in his own words. And then we'll dive into our live Q&A. So yeah, interesting headline here from Forbes. Caught my eye. Incredible Trump plan to take on the banks revealed amid Bitcoin and crypto price surge. So that's right. Bitcoin surged back this week after a sudden price crash, which took us all the way down to $49,000. And then we climbed back up, tapping 62. And now we're correcting currently above 58, between 58 and 59. Now, the Bitcoin price did climb over 61, adding $200 billion to the wider crypto market after former U.S. President Trump proposed a radical plan to pay off $35 trillion of U.S. national debt. Now, after teasing game-changing crypto plans all week, Trump's son, Trump Jr., revealed the Trump family is working on a decentralized finance crypto. That's right. DeFi cryptocurrency platform to take on the banks. Interesting, eh? Check this out. Rumors of a Trump crypto began swirling this week after a series of posts by Don Jr. and Trump's son, Eric, who teased the big crypto announcement. A new Solana-based crypto called Restore the Republic, or RTR, exploded in value before crashing back after viral rumors that it could be Trump's official crypto were nixed by Trump's son, Eric, who called the rumors absolutely false and said that the only official Trump project has not been announced. So there you have it. Quoting him here, I love how the crypto community is embracing Trump, Don Jr. posted to X. It is absolutely incredible, but beware of fake tokens claiming to be a part of the Trump project. The only official project will be announced directly by us, not Martin Scorsese, and it will be fair for everyone. Don't be fooled. Stay tuned for the real deal. So there you have it, coming directly from Trump Jr. And during the live stream Q&A on subscription-based platform Locals, Don Jr. said the mysterious and yet unnamed Trump project won't be a meme coin and will be a long-term play. So it's a DeFi platform to challenge the banks, and it is not another shitcoin, family. Quoting him here, there's a lot of guys doing great stuff. I love meme coins and that culture. I love what those guys are doing with some friends of mine. It's great, Don Jr. said, but I just have to make sure that the people understand that you can't conflate one thing with another. Don Jr. went on to give some more details of the plan that appears to be some sort of crypto-based payment and banking platform. Quoting him again, I think what we want to do is sort of take on a lot of the banking world. This notion of decentralized finance is obviously very appealing to guys like me who have been debanked or haven't been able to get insurance or whatnot. Amen. I mean, Bitcoin banking the unbanked, and is the only form of money in which can't be confiscated. So if you did get debanked or deplatformed, you still have a source of funds. Now, decentralized cryptos such as Bitcoin has been touted as an alternative to the centralized financial system, which has been criticized for becoming politicized in recent years, most notably by Canada's government that froze the bank accounts of anti-vaccine mandate protesters in 2022. Then last year, the Biden administration was accused of trying to quietly ban Bitcoin, Ethereum, and other cryptocurrencies in a move that was described as Operation Choke Point 2.0, referring to a 2013 government initiative that sought to cut off undesirable industries from banking services. So there you have it, crypto fam. Let me know your thoughts surrounding the Trump decentralized platform. Do you have any insights, projections, predictions? Holla at your boy. Now for our featured story of the day. Rich Dad author Robert Kiyosaki declares market crash has arrived and that the losses are substantial. And he also more recently made a very bold price prediction of Bitcoin hitting $10 million very easily. And I'm going to actually start there with the tweet that he posted. And let me timestamp it for you. This was back on July 3rd, 2024. Got 1 million views, got a lot of love. And I'm going to read it to you. According to Robert Kiyosaki, boom going bust. Technical charts indicate the biggest crash in history coming. Prices of real estate, stocks, bonds, gold, silver, and Bitcoin crash. Great news. It's a good time to buy bargains. It will follow. Technical charts indicate major long-term bull market cycle will follow starting bull market climb in late 2025, raising the prices for years. This bull market cycle is the boom gold, silver, and Bitcoin investors have been waiting for. Their patience will be rewarded. This is the long-term bull market cycle they knew had to come. They know it has come because the U.S. is the biggest debtor nation in history. They know this long cycle bull market is coming because they know faith and confidence in fake money is dissolving. Breach. They know history will repeat. They know what happened to Germany's Reichmark and the Zimbabwe dollar. They know more and more people are finally waking up. Amen to that. They know after the crash, the long cycle bull market for gold, silver, and Bitcoin will begin. They know after the crash, gold, silver, Bitcoin will once again begin climbing to hit all-time highs. Now for the most interesting part of this tweet. He goes on to share, gold possibly, keyword, possibly 15,000 an ounce. Silver possibly, again, keyword, possibly $110 an ounce. And then he goes on to say, Bitcoin easily, keyword, easily. Notice he doesn't say possibly, but purposely puts easily to $10 million per coin. I love and respect his confidence in Bitcoin. So shout out to Rich Dad, Robert Kiyosaki. They know to be patient. They know their time has arrived. Take care. Now, easy question for the fam in the chat. What has the biggest reward, right? Risk reward. What has the best reward and the least risk here? Run the math. Bitcoin today is less than 60,000. If we go to 10 million, clearly this has the most bullish potential, right? Now, what's the worst case scenario of Bitcoin? You tell me. What do you think is the absolute worst that can happen at a time like this in the cycle? Maybe we revisit 49, we potentially hit a lower low and go to 45, 42, something like that. What's the upside potential? $10 million per coin. Let that sink in. Now, gold, he says possibly, meaning he's not so convinced, right, is probably sitting at 2,000 an ounce. So what? It can go up maybe 7x. Meanwhile, again, can someone run the math? Divide $10 million divided by 60,000. It'll give us some idea or perspective of how much Bitcoin can climb from here based upon his own projection. Let me know. And where is the silver at an ounce right now? Let me know that one also. But clearly, Bitcoin has the most upside potential with the least risk, and he has the most confidence, and you should. It's the only decentralized form of money to ever exist. Obviously, the Fed and government and banking cartels like JP Morgan Chase, they spoof precious metal markets to control the assets and control the markets. And they pay big fines as a result, which is nothing new. And of course, they have relative scarcity, whereas Bitcoin has true, genuine scarcity, meaning there can only ever be 21 million Bitcoin in circulation. Gold and silver, they'll be finding forever till the end of time. They'll just be digging it out of the earth. It just is what it is. But anyways, let's break this baby down. So yeah, Kiyosaki highlighted advice from his rich dad mentor, emphasizing that the market downturn presents lucrative opportunities for the wealthy. He described, rich dad taught his son and me, when markets are crashing, that's the time to get rich, and that's when the rich get richer. Buying assets at bargain basement prices, amen to that. The acclaimed author post is a call to action for investors, urging them to view the market crash as a prime buying opportunity. He enthused, markets are crashing, great news, asset markets are having a sale. This is your turn to get richer. And that's the silver lining, especially when Bitcoin is correcting, family. And I want you to really consider that, right? People look at it like, oh my God, Bitcoin is down. And then smart people are like, wow, another great buy the dip opportunity. And someone like Saylor would be all over that, right? So Kiyosaki has long recommended gold, silver, and Bitcoin. He recently predicted an imminent economic crash followed by a major bull market with Bitcoin potentially reaching 10 million per coin, gold 15,000 an ounce, and silver 110 an ounce. He attributes this forecast to declining trust and fiat currencies as well as historical trends. So what are your thoughts on his particular prediction of Bitcoin easily hitting 10 million per coin? And my next question for you, by what year, realistically, can you see this coming into fruition and actually manifesting into our reality? Let me know your thoughts, fam, and I'll do my best to read the comments out loud. I think Bitcoin is too big to fail. Yes, definitely Bitcoin at the moment is the best asset for risk-reward terms. I look at every dip like this, honestly, as a buying opportunity. Well said, independent. The Oracle says that would be 166.7x JV. So Bitcoin has 166x potential, thank you. Whereas gold has 7x, according to Rich Dad. I mean, no questions asked right there. Bitcoin is the future. 110 silver at 15,000 gold. It is undervalued. More like 250 to 300 wick is still lower than the real value. Thank you, MJ. It's 166.6, 10 million divided by 60,000. Thank you, Mike. So clearly, Bitcoin has the most upside potential. Clearly, we're talking 166x. Mind-boggling. Versus 7x potentially for gold. Keyword, potentially. Possibly. Bitcoin, easily, certainly. So, the beast, if I were any better, I'd be you, JV. I dig it, Germ. Bitcoin since inception, 2009, up 450 million percent. Gold up 150%. Do your own math. I'm going to reread that. Bitcoin since inception 15 years ago, since January 3rd, when the Genesis block of 2009. Bitcoin is up 450 million percent. Gold is up 150%. Do the math. Thank you, Greg. Living in Thailand and having a Chinese wife, we bought gold, but my wife finally saw the light. We sold most our gold and bought Bitcoin. Well, happy to hear you got the biddies. 10 million, huh? I imagine this happening in the 2032 cycle. Send it, independent free soul. I'm so ready. Silver will do better than gold. Without silver, we are screwed for tech products. Hey, I got some gold in my crystal. There's a gold rod. It somehow enhances the power of the crystal. So they put the gold rods in there. So there's a little gold. Finally, a legitimate use case. Bitcoin must have gold and silver, just as a fire to a nuclear power plant. Oil is required. Can't be done without it. We need the biddies, but you need to have gold and silver too. Bitcoin beats them all. There's a reason we call Bitcoin the apex predator. Just saying. If Bitcoin goes to 10 million, that would be 10 cents per sat. That's right. Thanks for the math breakdown, the Oracle. And if one sat hit $1, one Bitcoin will be equivalent to $100 million. Again, if one Satoshi ends up being $1, then it means that one Bitcoin will be equivalent to $100 million. And if one Satoshi, as the Oracle just pointed out, hits 10 cents, Bitcoin will be worth $10 million per coin.